Hello everybody, welcome back to our coverage of the 2021 European Shooting Championships. This our last action from the shotgun range coming up. The women's trap team competition, as we take another look at some of the beautiful parts of Osijek. River, of course, dominating the landscape, as does the church, the co-cathedral. Beautiful part of the world. One of the main parts, the square, where all the trams travel through. The River Drava, of course, heading down towards the Danube, 25 kilometers away. And the Pampa shooting range, well, it's been around since 1784. Some of these athletes a little less than that. Qualifying for these team events from early this morning, and we've been covering all the finals for you. Hope you've enjoyed it. 60 finals. That's our part of the operations. Here's Kuna, the mascot, who's been at every single final as well, and is high-fiving all of our athletes as well. Finland against France, the first of the medal matches, the bronze medal match. And Finland with Noora Antikainen, the 39-year-old. This is the Olympic gold medalist from Beijing, Satu Mikaela Nummela, 50 years of age now. Her first medal was a world championship bronze back in 1995. So she's been going a while. And here's Mopsi Verooma, 40 years of age, a youngster by comparison. Post office worker by profession. Kari Kopra is the Finnish coach. And there's a good contingent of Finnish supporters in the stands as well. And they're up against a strong French team. Carole Cormenier got the bronze individually, of course, earlier in this competition. World Cup gold in Alain in 2019. European Championship silver in 2019 as well. And here's the youngster of this competition, Lomi Rakasan from St. Ginian, the Poussin Club, just 19 years of age. And Melanie Kuzi, a little bit older, world number 26, from the Lazenay Club. Stéphane Clément is our French coach with the VAR and the timeout at his disposal.
The jury member in charge for this final is Mr. Kostakis Xenofontos from Cyprus.
Well, this smiling face has been with us throughout the shotgun events, and he's here again to make sure things work out well.
And the referee for this final is Mr. Sergei Liko from Russia.
And another Russian referee in charge for this final.
One more big round of applause for ladies in trap team woman, bronze medal match.
So there's the French team and the Finnish team as well. Qualification. Well, there is no shoot-off needed. Finland qualifying fourth, France in third, a couple of points ahead, a couple of targets ahead. They were both quite a long way away from Russia and Italy. We'll see that, the gold medal match, as soon as this one is concluded. And these two medal matches, the last action of our shotgun program here at the European Shooting Championships. Kuzi gets us underway with a hit, followed by a no target. We'll go again for Lomi Rakasan. teenager, no medal, just one junior European Championship final, fourth in 2018. And she's having to wait to make her first target. Not great for the youngster. Probably a bundle of nerves, I'm sure. But doing her best not to show it. Satu Michaela Nomola, the veteran, a gold medalist. It's good to see her on the finals range. Seven times World Cup gold medalist. And is that a miss from Nori Antikainen? It is. So our first red of this bronze medal match. And a miss from Cormenier, the most experienced of the French athletes as well. Well, Mopsy Verama, you certainly hear her call, don't you? Very decisive. Better for Antikainen. One miss a piece then. It's going to be a tight one, you think? Unless we start missing like that. Kuzi with her first miss. Miss from Verama. So from a tight start, people starting to have a few difficulties. This might be a scramble to the first 2 points. So seven apiece, two more series for these teams. Will it be a share of the points? Another miss, this time the first one from the teenager. So advantage to Finland if they can bag these three. Oh, and a miss. That one straight away, but low. So three misses apiece, all down to these three targets. Oh, and a miss. Second in a row for Rakasan. Cormenier. No target called. And no target again. Another bit flying off that target. It's from the same position. I think the Ricasso had the problem earlier on. Now then, Verhoma finally gets a chance . Two more needed here. Took her time, the veteran, Olympic gold medalist. No misses from her. And it is 2 points to Finland. They take the first blood here. And France, well, we'll have to regroup. Just the 1 point, the difference. But winner takes all. First to six, of course. Tricky one for Verhoma. The Finns shooting first here. Oh, and another no target, and that is pretty sure the same trap that was causing us the problems all the way through. No problem when it finally does come for Antikainen. Double trap gold in the World Cup in Sydney back in 2004. Cousy starting France off well. Such a distinctive call, isn't it, from Verhoma? I think she's still calling as she shoots. Gassin keeping France in the green. Cormenier, 6 out of 6 for France. So can they get themselves back into this bronze medal match? Miss from Cousy, away to the left-hand side. Coach not challenging that with VAR. You can see that was a definite miss. So we're level again. With two series to go in this second round. Michaela Neumüller. Likes noise, trumpet player, when she's not doing this. So then pressure back on France. Pink powder just drifting around and heading back towards the athletes. Three hits here, put the pressure on the French. Oh, no, though. A miss from Mopsy Verhoma. Well, it might be a miss that lets the French back in here. Oh, there's another miss from Antikainen this time. Well, real chance here for France. Well, at least a point, just one of these next two. Down the middle, no problem at all. And we are back to level pegging. So 2 points apiece. Just Finland really coming apart at the seams in that last series. So, none the wiser as to who's getting closer to the 6 points. Title match, this bronze medal match. Remember, we've got a gold medal match coming up. Russia against Italy. Italy missing out on gold in the men's competition to back here. Now then, here's round three. Part of that being hit. And our first miss of this third round. It's Carole Cormier. Has a mixed team World Cup gold, the Frenchwoman from last year. In Nicosia. Good stuff from France the second time round. Finland, here's Veroma. Was ranked just outside the top 50. And there is a miss. So, I was about to say level after two, three targets there for Finland. But they missed two. Antikainen with that last one. And it is France who have the advantage here. Kuzi shooting well. The diminutive Rakarsan also yet to miss in round three. Keeping the advantage no matter what Finland can do here. Such a class act, isn't she, Satu and Michaela Nummela. Seven World Cup golds, but just a European Championship bronze individually. It's obviously just not the competition for her at the moment. Excellent from France, just the one miss. Every chance of coming from behind to lead here. Oh dear, it's slightly falling apart for Finland. It will be two more points surely for France. That will seal the deal. Make sure there are no more doubts. Finland with three more shots to go. It's not going to make any difference. They're an awful long way behind. Just the one miss for France. It'll be good for them to get some hits under their belt. Timeout called by Finland, not surprisingly. They are 4-2 down, having been 2-0 up. What will he have to say? What can he say to get this Finnish team back on track? So, of course, France win the next one. They've won the bronze. That's why the timeout's been called. Conversation over. It's a little bit more relaxed for Coach Klammer. Gary Coppera needing to do a bit more work getting the timeout ready and using it. So then, Finland need this win, but start with a miss. Yeah, not looking too happy in the stands, are they? And a second miss. Oh dear, what a start. Unless you think, as a coach, having given them a pep talk, and then there's three reds in a row. Oh dear. Well, you can only say the words, you can't make them hit. In fact, everyone's starting to miss now. Who's going to hit first? There we go. Just a nibble of it. Right then to Rakasa. Oh, another miss. Oh dear, what is going on with Finland at the moment? They've had a really tight contest. Oh, and the hand went up straight away for Antikainen. And VAR card goes up from the Finnish coach. Well, they desperately need this to be green, don't they? And she was convinced there was a hit. Hand went up straight away. Looked like a straightaway target as well, so she should have had a very good view of it. That isn't going to help much. The problem is the camera that you normally used to track right behind the athlete and the target right in front of the athlete. That's a tricky one, isn't it? She was absolutely convinced she'd hit it. Still checking. Not easy on that view, is it? And they've made their decision. Antikainen watching on. They have to see some evidence, don't they? That's the problem. Ah, there you go. Well, perhaps a lifeline. Oh, they're still a long way behind. From Rakasa. No problems from Cormenier. They still have a couple of targets in hand in this series, in this search for bronze. Thank you. That's better from Finland. Perhaps it's a little too late. Yeah, got a bit of that one. Each green for France brings them closer to that bronze medal. What can Verouma do here? No target. It's from position number four, so it's not the same as we've had. I think it's position two generally we've had problems. Yep, still calling as she hits it. That's better from the 40-year-old. That's not so good though from Satu Makelo Nurmala, and surely now the bronze is within grasp. Just need this decent series to put them three ahead. Oh no, there's a red for Kuzi. No problems though for the teenager. Well, they need to hit everything here and just keep their fingers crossed. Oh, there is a miss. Well, this, well, they're level. And if France miss everything, they get a share of the points. We carry on. Just one hit needed here to take it, the bronze medal for France. I think that might well have been a no target. Certainly flew very high in the air. Right, a slight delay in settling this bronze medal match. It's that second station that's causing the problems with the targets, isn't it? But we're almost there. France are almost over the line. That will do it. And the coach can relax. This is the last shot then. It's a comfortable victory in the end for France. 6 points to two after being 2 points to nothing down. Melanie Kuzi, Luomi Rekasan and Carole Cormenier. Excellent work from them. And France take the bronze medal. Finland having to settle for fourth. So then time for the gold medal match, our last action here on the shotgun range for this European Championships. Last time to see Kuna outside in the sunshine, enjoying the warmth, I'm sure. It's Russia against Italy. Here's Jessica Rossi. The 29-year-old got the silver in the individual event, of course, the Olympic champion from London. 2012. Here's the 28-year-old Silvana Stanko, the left-hander, born and lives in Switzerland, but is an Italian through and through when it comes to her shooting. Winterthur, her residence. And the 26-year-old Fiammetta Rossi, bronze in Delhi earlier this year in the World Cup. And she does have a European Championship junior silver. And here he is again. We saw him in the men's competition, now coaching the women. And now the Russian team, who qualified top by 0.1 point with a European record. Yulia Savileva, the 23-year-old. She does have a trap team gold from this year already. Ekaterina Subotina, fourth in the individual event, just missing out on the medals. Got the bronze in the World Cup in Cairo this year as well, so showing what she can do. And this is Daria Semyonova, gold for the 18-year-old individually. Serious prospect for the future. World Cup silver in Cairo as well this year. And a team gold, of course, in Cairo as well, part of that team alongside Soleva. Once again, to remember in charge is from Cyprus.
And the referee for this final is Mr. Dražen Božić from Croatia.
And a local man in charge, the referee, Dražen Božić.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more applause for our track team women gold medal.
That's the Russians, who will fancy their chances. A very strong team indeed. 487, their qualification, 477, actually 11 points behind. Italy, they were a country mile ahead of France as well at 465, so the two best teams by quite some distance. Spain, Slovakia and Germany, the teams missing out. So, what is it, just past 7 o'clock local time. We are about to get underway with our last action here at the shotgun range. Just one more competition tomorrow indoors at lunchtime, and then we are done and dusted and heading home. Subotina with a miss. Another no target. Having a few problems in the heat today. Rossi getting us underway for Italy. Fiammetta Rossi, that is. Silvana Stanko. Jessica Rossi now to get us past our first series and get the Italians 1 point into the lead. Early on, though, could all change. A bit of warmth in that sun. Oh, another miss. And he's out of his seat, the Russian coach, and waving the VAR around frantically. Russians in the stand adding their views as well. So round we go. asking for the video. Let's have a look. Oh, you see the shot from the Russian, and the target's already out of frame, so they're going to have to look somewhere else. There's the need to keep panning. Keep moving. Let's have a look. Keep moving. Because that's where the shot is taken. Keep it going. Let's have a look. I'm afraid you're not going to see anything from that angle, that camera angle, unfortunately. Is there anywhere else we can look? Looking for different angles. That's the problem. That the shot from the shotgun comes as the target goes out of vision. By the time we pick it up again, the evidence has kind of disappeared, if there was any. Well, let's see what they say. There's no real evidence on the screen. Will they stick with their original decision? Oh, the decision is overturned. Still trailing by one. The only miss, from Subotina. Nice from Yulia Savileva. Now Fiametta Rossi. Tricky one away to the right. No problems for her. So far, so green for Italy. Ooh, that might be the first miss. Yes, it is. Oh, and here we go for VAR again. I'm not sure that was inspired by the shouts from the crowd. French coach just looking at his watch. They've got the medal ceremonies after this. We're already quite a long way behind schedule.
After six targets by each team, Russia has 5 hits. Italy also has 5 hits. They only have 1 miss and this 6 targets.
So this is quite important. Let's have a little look here at the target. You can hear the noise of the shotgun as they run the tape forwards and backwards. Is there anything to suggest there is a hit there? Perhaps a slight variation. A little wobble will give a suggestion of a hit. It's not spinning smoothly. Well, they've made their decision. Out they come. Will it be another overturn? Keep an eye on the Italian coach. Well, red goes to green. Italy with a point advantage. Semyonova shooting well. As we expect from the gold medalists from the individual event. Oh, and another miss. I don't think that's going to be contested from Savileva. Very distinct call again, this time from Stanko. Talking about the Finnish athlete, weren't we? A little bit earlier on. Mopsi Veruma. And a miss from Jessica Rossi. Straight down the middle, a miss by Semyonova, her first of this round. And another miss from Subotina. Well, handing on a plate to Italy here. That's assuming Italy can sort these three shots out. That one rising steeply, not a problem for Fiammetta Rossi, inside the world top 10 at the moment. Oh, that is a miss. Still an advantage though for Italy. Can Jessica Rossi hammer that one home? No is the answer. It's still tight, isn't it? Now, given those two misses in the last round, the last series. Russia looking to take the most of the opportunity. Well, only one behind in terms of misses. Italy with three targets to try and take the 2 points. Oh, and there's a miss. And there's another miss. Wow, what a swing. What a move. What a change. And that's not a smile of pleasure, I can assure you, from Albano Pero. Last one is no target. Take it again. Is academic though. Look at the reds stacking up in the last two series. And a timeout unsurprisingly called by the Italians as Russia go into a, let's be honest, a surprise 2 point lead. He's very experienced, isn't he? He's been sitting in the coach's chair for a large proportion of these shotgun finals in the trap. So then, Russia looked like they were down and out in that one. Italy handing it to them on a plate that first round. Who can take the second round? Italy starting us off. There's another one that's flown away. Sabotella setting herself again. Jessica Rossi with the only miss so far. And goes up, miss from Semyonova. The bottom of that. Must have taken a nibble that one. Didn't look like it, but the referee's arm stayed down. No question about that one. Winner miss from Fiametta Rossi. Well, he's had his time out now, hasn't he? Just starting to drop down over our left shoulders. Bit chillier in the shade, not so much, I think, in the sun. Semyonova back into the green. What about Sabotella? That looked like a miss to me. The hand went up. Oh, no, it's a broken target, I think. And that is a hit. That one certainly not. Two misses apiece. Two series left in this round. Another broken target. Just to add to the length of this gold medal match. And that is a miss. A second in a row from Fiametta Rossi. Italian coach looking fairly sanguine about it all. But they could go into a 4-0. Trailing situation is just at the moment. Too many inconsistencies. Stanko shooting very well, the other two not. Sabotella also shooting well. So, good advantage going into this fifth series here for Russia. They've had their time out. They're in a spot of bother. Oh dear, that's another miss. So just the one needed to take it to 4-0. That'll do it. They can relax on the other two. Nicely done. It's a good finish. Some great shooting and a big margin. 3 points the difference. And now Russia just 2 points away from the gold medal in this women's team trap competition. Excuse me, team trap competition. Another time out for Italy.
And now we're moving on with the finals.
Well, will this be the last series we see on this finals range in the European Championships, or can Italy fight back? Russia getting underway with Daria Semyonova. Now Sabotina. Oh, that was a miss, was it not? No, hand stayed down. That would have been a no target. Let's see if she's taking that again. I think she is. No problems this time. Up and to the left. No problems for Rossi. These Italian women have to shoot well in this round. Stanko, I think, bothered by a... There was a very large bee wasp type thing flying around a little while ago. I hope it hasn't made its way to the final area. So far, so good for the Russians. Keep it tight here. Ooh, and there is a miss. Our first miss of this third round. Followed by one from Italy. No problems for Stanko. To the right, a little bit easier to track for the left-hander. Is a miss. So two misses now from Russia. Down in the middle, more or less, for Sovaleva. So can Italy get a foothold in this gold medal match? Not with a miss. Second in a row for Fiametta Rossi. Oh dear, and there's another one. Jessica Rossi this time. Easy enough for Semyonova down the middle. Now Sobotina. And that'll have to be taken again, another broken target. Dealt with it that time, no problems at all. So one ahead in terms of the misses, just the two compared to the three from Italy. And we're getting close to the denouement here. It's very tight, but this could be three greens here, and it's the gold for Russia. Semyonova, perfect. No target again. Oh dear. One more then to make sure of gold for Russia to be unassailable. And listen to the cheers and look at the reaction from the coach. Well, they had to work hard in their first round of this match. Italy started to miss and threw away those 2 points. And this is not going to make any difference to the score. There you go. 6 points for Russia. They take the gold here in Osijek at the European Championships. In the last action here in the shotgun events. Excellent work. And really convincing. Congratulations to Italy as well. They take the silver to go alongside France's bronze. Well, the shadow's all the way across now. The athletes won't mind that. They have another medal. And these are 3 sets of athletes. Confirmation, France take the bronze, Italy with the silver, and Russia with the gold.
Ladies and gentlemen, the victory ceremony for JAP Team Women and JAP Team Men will be held at the final hall in 15 minutes. Please all the finalists come to the award ceremony.